So I get a lot of questions from people saying that their iPhone or iPad is giving them warnings about being filled up, about there not being any extra space, and they don't know how to solve the problem. And it's pretty easy to do because there's a really useful tool inside Settings. So if you go inside Settings here and then you go to General, and then from there you go to Storage and iCloud Usage, and you want the storage part of this. And you can see it tells you used and available. So I've got plenty of space, but you may see here that you're in danger of being almost out of space. You go to Manage Storage, and it's going to give you the details of all the apps that you've got installed and how much space they're using. So each app you can actually select and get more information. Most of the time you're not going to get too much. So let's take a look at something like, for instance, look at Keynote. So the total space there is 565.6 megs. I tap on that and it shows me at the top that the app size is 565.4 megs. And you can see 242K are taken up with documents and data. So it gives me an idea of whether or not it's the app using the space or it's a bunch of documents that I've got stored. If I look at something else like Audible, I can see that the app itself is pretty small, 46.7 megs, and documents and data is half a gig there. I can't really do much except delete the entire app, which would delete the app and all the data. But in this case, with an app like Audible, I can actually go into the app itself and remove content, and then that would be reflected here. You do that with a lot of different apps, like say Amazon Prime Video. You could go in and delete videos that you've saved there, and that it would free up space. So sometimes you can do it here, but sometimes you can't. So for instance, like under Music, I can actually see like a breakdown of albums and songs, and I can actually delete a song right from inside of the Settings app. So you have that option. Other times you get some more information, like for instance photos and camera. It tells me that my shared photo stream is so big and my photo library is so big. And so I can make decisions based on that. So you get a lot of information here. It's sorted, of course, with the largest users of space at the top. So you can decide maybe there's a game here that you're not using anymore, and you can easily select it, hit delete app. It's an easier way to delete apps, especially if you're going to do many of them, to free up space and to get an idea of what it is that is taking up space on your iPhone or iPad.